Hello everyone.
Hi, we're back. We found a few days of holidays and it's autumn now and we're back here for some work on the container and the property.
Yep. So it's really amazing here. Now all the nature is getting ready for winter.
So what we have is, this is how it looks at the moment. We unlocked the container now, we have light inside. So it's been sitting here for about 1 month and a half. It looks good. It seems that our bed of rock plays really well.
We also have the insulation on the interior and we will continue to isolate the floor as well. And also remove all the excess foam. So that's what we are gonna be working on the next few days. Isolation, and hopefully in February next year we will be able to stay in the container.
Yeah, so we got some tools. Just, I forgot the name of the saws, but one manual one and one of these. We have a few batteries as well. And basically we think it will work, but we shall see.
Let's get started.
We are back. This is the second day on the container, or the third, no, the second full day of work. And today it's sunny.
Yeah, we have amazing weather today.
Where is the sun?
It's somewhere there.
Huh?
Near the forest.
No, you can see the sun, no? Okay, now you can, I guess. Anyway.
So we are also lucky because we have our solar panel. And today we can charge the battery.
So, we are mostly finished with one part, actually from the top, from the bottom to nearly the top, because there we have a bunch of overhang from the foam, so we have to do the 90 degree corner. Oh, it was tougher than expected. Something like here we need to do like a 90 degree corner, and then the worst is the ceiling. Because the ceiling is basically it's hard to get into there with the stair and everything, but hopefully we'll make it.
Here we are applying a mylar roll, which is acting as a radiation deflector. We put it with a mylar face down, so it will radiate the cold back to the underside of the container. It was easy to work with and actually quite fun. We made sure it's seamless with some aluminium tape. Here I'm applying polyurethane coating for hydrological insulation. We did this for all rooms in two layers so that condensation will not be a problem.
After the radiation layer, we used XPS foam panels, which is a harder foam that you can walk on it. This is the thermal and sound insulation layer. We used 5 cm panels for our context, as we had 11 cm to work with until the door cut out. Working with XPS was really fun, as it cuts easy and it can be glued with polyurethane glue. It was like a big puzzle for us. As you might have noticed, we like polyurethane as a substance. It's very versatile, resistant to many environmental factors, and if used correctly, it will be part of the project for life. We wanted to lead a more regenerative lifestyle, and that includes the materials we choose for building our house. We want them to last for our lifetime or even more. For example, the CO2 emitted while manufacturing all the polyurethane in our house will help us save at least 100 times more CO2 in heating our house for its entire lifespan. All insulation materials have cost in CO2 emissions. However, polyurethane is the best material when it comes to efficiency.
We had the same process for all our rooms. Hydrological barrier, radiation barrier, thermal and phonic barrier. In part 2, we will continue the floor insulation and we will add another layer of thermal and hydrological insulation. See you next week!